My name is Russell. I'm a teacher and a running coach. I'm almost 40 years old, and until I was 38, I was an agnostic or an atheist or someone who was committed to disproving or stubbornly refusing to believe that there is a God. To me, believing in Jesus as a great teacher or a great philosopher was right on, but you know, burning bushes don't speak, and men don't walk on water, and I could never take the leap of faith to believe any of that. I was always a very proud person that I could deal with any kind of problem in my life, that anything the world threw at me, I could handle on my own. But through conversations with people that God was putting in my life, and through many things that were happening in my life, things started to change. With a family that didn't see me very much, kids who needed more than just an English teacher who graded papers, or a coach who just knew about paces and miles and winning races, I felt this growing presence in my life. I felt this almost like a weight in my life. It was growing because I was continuing to do what I'd always done in my life, and that is to try to handle everything on my own. Right before I went for a run one Sunday morning, I just gave up and got on my knees, and for the first time in my life as a 38-year-old, I prayed to God that He would forgive me, that He would help me, that I couldn't do it on my own anymore, and that I needed Him. It's the first time I had ever actually tried to speak to God. And I didn't know if it was gonna work. I didn't know how prayer worked. And I felt better, I felt lighter, I felt renewed, but I didn't know what it all meant. I didn't know what was happening. But what was happening in my life for the first time was something much greater than any of that. I was beginning to trust God. And God, who had pursued me my entire life, He didn't take very long. He spoke to me a couple days later through my son. One of my sons, while we were just riding down the road, out of the blue, just 2 days after my prayer, said 8 words, and they were the 8 most powerful words of my life. And I can't say that God spoke to me, but I can say that God spoke to me through my son. Riding down the road that day, my little 6-year-old at the time just said, "Daddy, when are you gonna talk to me about Jesus?" And I knew. My wife and my sons mean more to me than anything in the world, and to have my son reach out to me innocently and openly and just ask me to teach him about Jesus, that's the moment I knew that I believed in God and that Jesus was my Savior. God just refused to give up on me. He started working in my life through some friends of mine, one that bought me a Bible, one that just would not stop talking to me about Jesus no matter what I said, no matter how many times I told him I wouldn't ever believe in Jesus. God just would not give up on me. He took somebody like me who can have good influence on so many different people because I teach, because I coach, because I'm a husband and a father, because I'm around so many people that need to know about God. I think God decided He would use me. I'm so happy that I finally realized that after trying to run away from Him when He was pursuing me and pursuing me, and now I'm so happy that I'm running with Him.